Elijah, when he came down, the queen of that place, she said, tomorrow by this time I am going to kill you. You killed 420 prophets of mine, tomorrow I will kill you. Suddenly, a kind of fear from the evil spirit came and attacked Elijah. In your life also, you may be noticing, everything is okay. Suddenly, your mind gets something upset. You don't know what is happening. Suddenly, you get frightened. Suddenly, you feel everything was okay. Suddenly, you realize something is going wrong with you. These are the moments, attacks of the enemy. When Elijah was attacked, he did not know what to do. He became upset. Lord, I did so much for you, and now at the end, what did I get? He got angry on the Lord. Sometimes we do many things for God. We do many good things for others. Suddenly things go wrong. The people whom we blessed and helped, they themselves attack us. We get upset. Lord, I did always good. Why these things are happening to me? That is the moment the enemy will come. When you are disturbed, he will come and he will make your life miserable. That's what he did to Elijah. You served God. Now what has happened? The queen is going to kill you. So, with the depression, Elijah was running. He was running. He didn't know whether he is eating or not. He is walking all day. When your mind is depressed, you will not know what you are thinking, what you are talking. He was upset. And he went to a broom tree and he was sleeping, under which there are snakes and scorpions. When you are depressed, you will not know what you are talking, where you are going. Sometimes you are thrown where the Satan himself is there. Snakes and scorpions are there. But the God who called you is faithful. He will not let you down. Maybe in your weakness, you've gone to wrong places. But the God who loves you, who has brought you into the world, whom you trust, will not leave you. We read in 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 5, God sent his angel. The Bible says the angel woke up Elijah and said, get up. Whenever we have fallen, the language God will speak is, get up. My son, get up. My daughter, I am there with you, get up. And Elijah got up and saw bread and water. He ate the bread, he drank the water, again he slept. Sometime God guides us and we don't listen to him, again we fall. That's what happened to Elijah. God never gets discouraged with our discouragement. God never gives us up, even when we have fallen again and again. When God has not given you up, why should you give up yourself? Elijah gave up. He slept again. He did not listen to God. He did not get up. But God never gave him up. Again, he sent the angel. Again with the bread, again with the water, nourished Elijah and said to him, my son, get up and look at that mountain. Go to the mountain. I will speak to you. I will anoint you with my spirit. When Elijah got up, the enemy came. The moment you want to grow in the Lord, the enemy will come to attack you. But you have to hold on to the promise of the Lord. You have to hold on. Till today, God has protected you. tomorrow also he will take care of you. You have to fill your mind with the faith. Elijah, now when he was climbing on the mountain, suddenly the enemy brought heavy rain. But Elijah said, I will not be afraid. When I was hungry, when I was lying under the tree, near the tree under which snakes and scorpions, my God protected me. Will he not protect me from the rain? I don't care. When problems come, you have to open your lips and confess your faith in the Lord. You have to confess how God has kept you in the past, and he will take care of you in the future also. You have to open your lips and say the word of God. If God is for us, who can be against us? My grace is sufficient for you. In your weakness, my strength will sustain you. I can do everything through Christ who strengthens me. All those who are tired in life, come to me. I will give you rest. Any promise that you remember, immediately, the easiest thing, when you are disturbed, immediately bring a word of God to your mind. And you continue to say, when you are saying, the Holy Spirit who gave the word of God, he will come and he will take control of your thinking, your mind. When Elijah saw the enemy is bringing the heavy rain, he said, I don't care. My God, even in this desert, he brought the angel and gave me food. Will he not take care of me from the rain? He was climbing. But the enemy is not giving up. Until we have this flesh on this earth, the enemy will continue to trouble us, disturb us. Temptation will come. Things will go wrong. But that is not the end of the story. Shakespeare says, don't complain that the stars are not giving you enough light. Wait for the day, you will get plenty of it. When the enemy brings problems into your life, don't get disturbed. Call upon the Lord and he will supply you the enough light to face the darkness. You have darkness because there is no light. The darkness dares to enter into your house because the light is off. Put on the light, darkness will disappear. That's why in the book of Leviticus, chapter 6, verse 9, it is written, at the altar of your heart, the light of God should never be put off. Take care, at the altar of your heart, the light of God continues to burn. The moment you feel the absence of the presence of God, immediately take a word of God. Immediately remember a miracle of Jesus. Bring the word of God into your mind. So when Elijah was walking, now Satan got upset. I brought the rain. This fellow is not listening to me. Now he brought a heavy breeze. Elijah said, nothing happened. Nothing will happen to me. My God is for me. Who can be against me? If my God could protect me from all this till today, he will take care of me tomorrow also. And the enemy did not give up. Now he brought, the whole mountain is shaking. Earthquake. But Elijah said, nothing doing. My God is able to face even the earthquake.